Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's video we are going to be reviewing this watercolour set that has been gifted to me by the team over at Grabby. So if you watched my last video where we did a painting together, I'm not the strongest watercolour artist, however I'm determined to get back into painting and using a selection of different mediums, and yeah, this was very kindly sent to me for review and I thought we could go through a thorough rundown of what's in this box. So the packaging's lovely. I really like this design on it, and it did come wrapped in plastic actually, and I've just taken the plastic off, but that's all that I've done. In here we've also got exclusive detail paintbrush, water brush pen, sponge and a watercolour swatch sheet. 50 different colours, highly pigmented, high saturation, easy to blend, non-toxic, and it says they're premium. And the description of this particular set of watercolours says that they are professional. So let's have a look. It's really lightweight actually, so I'm interested to see what the packaging looks like. Oh, okay, so. Okay, I've never actually experienced one of these before, like a little swatch sheet with all of the different shades in. That's interesting. We can go through and do all of those. If you've watched any of my other like unboxings of new art supplies videos, you know that I am an actual sucker for the names of paints and things and pencils. But yeah, when they've got like cute names like Peach. Oh, what am I saying? So let's do the brushes first. So these are synthetic. Oh, why is that one stuck? And they've got quite an interesting handle actually. I don't have any brushes that are like this. Not gonna lie, I don't like that they're all individually wrapped in plastic. I don't know if that's necessary or not, because they have got the protective cover on the end of the brushes. So I don't know how necessary them being wrapped in plastic is, but I don't know if brushes when they're straight out of the factory, I don't know as a standard if they come wrapped in plastic, I don't know. But I've never experienced that with, you know, other paintbrushes and things, that they're individually wrapped. So I'm just going to unwrap all of these and yeah, take a look at all of the different sizes. Okay, so the first thing that I'm noticing is there's not a great deal of difference in the size options. So we have got, let's put them in order, so all of the zeros down there, and 1, 2, 3. So we've got, okay, that's the wrong way around, Ellis. It will be 000, 00, 0, 1, 2, 3. So they are the sizes that we have. And I'm not actually seeing a great deal of difference in these four brushes. So all of the zeros and number one, I'm not seeing a great deal of. Let's make it fair and take the covers off. So yeah, I don't know if you can see those. There is a bit of difference, but not huge. I'm not sad about having so many tiny brushes, because if you have detail brushes yourself, you'll know that they're the ones that get trashed first, no matter how well you try and look after them. Although if you speak to my husband, who does miniature model painting for a living, he will tell you different. These two are a bit chunkier. Let's see how they perform. They're quite soft. They're not rough, nasty. They don't feel super cheap. They look pretty decent. So yeah, let's move on to the actual palette. I am hoping to improve my overhead setup very soon, by the way. I've got a new lamp coming and an overhead attachment thing, so that we don't have the legs of my tripod in the shot. It's been bothering me for months and months, and I've decided to finally do something about it. So the tin, you know, it's nice. It's a nice little presentation. So it's also designed to be portable, which is why it's presented in this way. So yeah, let's crack it open. Right, let's see. We do have a water brush in here. I don't have many of these, so that's fun. Very flimsy bristles. Like, they, can you actually, can you see how much much, it just sort of stays. Yeah, we'll give it a test. That we'll see. We'll see how it performs. I don't know how I feel about brush pens, to be honest. But having said that, I don't really, you know, I'm not the biggest user of them, so I don't think I've had a big enough spectrum of experience to say. And then we've also got a square brush. This is kind of misshapen, and it's not very flat. It's a bit. In fact, the bristles look like they have actually been twisted in there, like they're not very straight. I don't know if that's how they're supposed to be. Can you see that, how they're like kind of wonky? Interesting. Then we have a little spongy sponge. So you've got a little cover to protect your paints, and here are our colours. I'm going to turn them around this way so you can see. So I have watched some other videos on Grabby products, and a general sort of thing that I picked up on was there are a few repeats of very similar sort of shades. We're not going to know ourselves, should I say, until we get them down on the swatch paper. But just first impressions, there is a nice selection in here, but putting them down on paper, I'd be interested to see how these sort of look all together, because even in real life, I know colours sometimes look different on camera, but even in real life, these ones look very similar. As do these two greens, look identical. This colour here is interesting to me. What is that? I think it's meant to be dark turquoise from what the swatch sheet says. I guess as well you could just keep that over the top maybe, like, so that you know the names of the colours if you needed to know that. Anyway, these two are really pretty. I like those. This is an exceptionally bright pink, and this is a really bright purple too. So should we get swatching and we'll see just how these sort of look when they're on the paper. I'm also happy to see that this looks like it's cold pressed, which is my preference when it comes to painting on watercolour. Let's get swatching. Right, so I've just filled in yellow ochre, and just to kind of show you what that looks like in the palette, I was a bit confused that was actually even going to be yellow. So that is a really pleasant surprise, and it just goes to show that a swatch sheet of any new colours for any new art supplies that you get is always a pretty good idea. I've also filled the entire box. As I was doing it, I thought people are going to get upset if I don't fill the entire box. I know sometimes that makes people uncomfortable. Yeah, let's move on to the next one. I'll probably speed this process along, but so far I actually really love the feel of the brush and how it picks up on the paint. Yeah, let's keep going. Okay, do you know what? It is kind of difficult to stay inside the lines when you're trying to be speedy. Smooth this one out a little bit more. So I actually do really love the colours. I love how they feel with the brush and how they go onto the paper. I love how they behave on the paper. There are some repetitions. There's some really, really similar colours. There was two over here, like these three are very, very similar. These ones down here, again, very, very similar. I have to say, it makes me really uncomfortable when brands use the term skin colour, just because there's so many different skin colours. I don't know how we can call just one shade skin colour. It could have been called something like apricot or peach or even bone, because it is so light on the paper. And as I was working along, filling in each colour, and I read skin colour, I was just like, oh, here we go. A lot of brands do this. It's something that I would love to see changed because I think it is very old fashioned. It is something that I will feed back to Grabby. But yeah, apart from that, the colours are lovely to work with. They're really, really nice. My favourite one has to be this olivey green down here. And I do love some of these browns too. They dry quickly, and as you've just seen from the purple down here, this one's bled out quite a bit, but that could just be me using the paint and maybe being a bit heavy-handed or grabbing a fair amount of the stuff when I was trying to do it quickly. They do reactivate a little bit when you, so if I show you this one down here, you can see that I'm able to smooth it out a bit, so it does reactivate ever so slightly, which some watercolours don't. That's more of a gouache sort of quality. But yeah, these reactivate ever so slightly, so that's cool. So if you do get a bit of a pooling of the colour, you could just, you know, try and massage it a little bit and it will smooth out. They are wonderfully pigmented, I have to say. I'm not really a big fan of the, you know, like the more fluorescent sort of colours, like this pink one here, this particularly bright purple, and this one here. But apart from that, it has got a lovely selection of colours. It's a nice set for £30. I just wish that this could have an ever so slight upgrade because it's very, very flimsy. It's, you know, it's, I don't know, it just doesn't feel the best, and I feel like it lets the set down. I know packaging isn't everything, but it just, I don't know, first impressions of it, it just feels a bit eh. Okay, so what I've actually done is I've sketched out this little deer, and I thought that we could attempt together to get more of a feel for watercolours and just explore the different colours a little bit more. So, just some thoughts on actually using the paints with this deer that I sketched out. I will confess that I did take a picture of this sketch before I started painting because I'm not very confident with watercolours. What I wanted to do was just save a copy so that if it did go terribly wrong, then I could take this digitally and do it again because I really liked the sketch. So for me, I was like, oh, don't ruin it. But I actually really, really liked how this turned out. It's not perfect, but it's definitely progress from when I've done previous watercolour paintings recently. And to be perfectly honest with you, this is one of the nicest sets that I've used in my granted limited experience, but I had such a lovely time. It was definitely a mix of the paints themselves, and also I actually really like the brushes. I showed the brushes to my husband, and yes, while they're not going to last very long, brushes always have, like, they gain a bit of a curve to them, and you'll notice with, particularly with detail brushes, is no matter what you do, you can't keep the point. No matter how well you look after them, they always start to curve over at the end, but they are so soft and so lovely to work with that I'm going to try my best to look after them as best as I can and just see how long they're going to last. But they were a joy to use, so I actually really like how this turned out. I would love to try and scan it in anyway, take it into Procreate and just see if I can tidy it up a bit, just maybe add some more details digitally and then turn it into a Christmas card for this year, because I actually really, really liked it. And I was surprised actually at how much I did enjoy using watercolours, because they usually terrify me. So yeah, as I say, I do think it is a really decent set for the money that you pay, which is around £30. It would make a lovely little gift set with the festive season fast approaching. And thank you to Grabby for sending them to me to test out. I had a lot of fun using them, and I hope you all enjoyed watching the process as well. Take care, everyone, and I will speak to you soon.